Hi everyone, this is JCRP and welcome to Media Melon. In this fourth episode, we're going to complete the mechanical build. The x-axis is already done. We're going to attach the belt in the x-axis, the motors. We're going to complete the y-axis, the belt for that. All in all the mechanical part will be done in this part. So let's get started. In Fusion 360, I was able to model the exact dimension of the y-axis build plate. It has the linear bearing positions and where to drill the hole positions. I printed them out in actual size on A4 and then stuck them together. Now I can cut out just the piece that I need and use some paper glue to stick it to the MDF. This is 18mm MDF and after cutting this is the result. I am going to drill holes here to accept the linear bearings. On the top side of the MDF, I am countersinking some holes to accept the head of the Allen key. This would keep the surface flush. Then mounting becomes straightforward by adding screws and nylock nuts. The smooth rods need to be parallel to each other for the smooth y-axis motion. So I move the plate to each end and then tighten the screws. The next would be motor and belt mounts. This houses the motor, but first we will make the belt tensioner. This is the tensioning screw and the flange bearing. I bought these off eBay and these are usually used with 3D printers. All the parts were printed with 5mm thickness, so they are plenty strong. Now on this flange bearing, the belt can rotate and this screw will tension the belt. To attach it to the frame, I can use the T-nuts that I had already included in the first episode. The belt tensioner is attached to the front of the machine. Adding the belt tensioner in the front means the motor mount obviously has to be placed in the back. When I designed the x-axis, I did not know where I will be attaching the belt, so I designed this piece separately. But now that all is set up, I can measure and add this to the Fusion model. So when you download, you can find the matching holes in the model. To hold it in place, I added some super glue. Once it dries, it is strong enough. Still, I chose to add some screws for extra strength. Here I am eyeballing the placement of the motor. It has to be in line with the belt holder. Then I can screw the motor holder in place and then mount the motor to it. This is the 20 teeth GT2 pulley that I am attaching to the motor. On the other side, I can now attach the belt tensioner. The GT2 belt I used was 6mm wide and had a pitch of 0.2mm. This is very common one used in most of the CNCs that you can buy from Banggood. Fixing it will be as simply as rolling it through the motor and the belt tensioner and then connecting it to the back with zip ties. It is necessary that while making the first loop, I add it as tight as possible and without much slack. Only then a little bit of tensioning can make the belt strong. After tensioning, here I am manually moving the x-axis to see if the belt stays within the pulley. For the y-axis, I made the small belt holder. Again, while designing, I did not know where the position. But now, after physical construction, I can measure and add it to the Fusion model. So while downloading, you can see the markings for this piece in the design. Flipping the entire machine on its side helps in mounting this. GT2 belts are manufactured with some metal linings, which makes them very strong for such purposes. The GT2 belt that I used on my 3D printer works fine till date. With that, the mechanical build is all done. With that, the mechanical build is all done. We have the x-axis, the z-axis and the y-axis completed. Usually a threaded rod is used when it comes to making a CNC to move the axis. But I set myself on a challenge to make the CNC with the GT2 belt just to see how it works, and I can't be more happier with my decision. All that remains is adding the CNC shield, the Arduino, gerbil and tweaking, mostly electronics. So hopefully that will be the last part of the series. And to not miss the last part, please subscribe to the channel. I'm sure that you have tons and tons of questions. I have written a detailed article series in Instructable, so the link is in the description. Please do check that. If this video helped you learn something, then please share it with your friends. Just by sharing, you help me and this channel a lot. Until next time, happy learning!